Podcast.
Hello, welcome to Let's Play Quest for Glory. So you want to be hero? Sure, why not? I'll give it a try. My name is Amethyst Lunatari. I'm playing this together, sort of, with the CRPG Addict and the Adventure Gamer. You can find them. They have blogs at crpgaddict.blogspot.com and advgamer.blogspot.com. They are blogging through playing the first edition of the game, the EGA version. And I am playing, however, the VGA remake or re-release, however you'd like to call it. Interesting thing about this game is it was originally was called Hero's Quest. So you want to be a hero. And they changed the name because there was a board game that came out around that time called Hero Quest. So I'm not sure if it was a legal thing, a legal matter, or it was just they were trying to prevent a legal matter or some confusion or something like that. It was changed to Quest for Glory, which I think is a better name because it was really too similar to the King's Quest, Police Quest, Space Quest games. So, and they were really obsessed with having, you know, everything named something Quest. But anyway, the introduction while I talk some more, talk about how I got this game. Well, I got it from Good Old Games, GOG.com, for $9.99. Had a bit of a problem getting it. We have no money in the account. We have a debit card that I usually use. We had no money in the account, so I went down to a check cashing place and got myself a pay-as-you-go internet card. Figured, okay, put $10 on it. Went to GOG.com. Well, first I had to activate the card, and then it said, press something for balance. I'm like, let me just check that the $10 is on there and everything's good. At which point, they informed me that they were taking 50 cents to check the balance. So at that point, I didn't have enough money on there to get the game. So, it didn't work. The Good Old Games, naturally. So, it was a couple days later. We actually got some money in our account, but for some reason the card didn't work at GOG.com at all. So I'm like, okay, that's just great. I'm gonna play a magic user actually. That didn't work. Have to click that? Okay. Just to stop them from doing that endlessly. Yeah, so I'm like, well, I have a PayPal account. I just have to put some money in the PayPal account. So, by the way, I'm walking everywhere because we have one car and the car is with the other one who's at work, so. I walked to Walmart and got one of those green dot money packs I tried to get it to put on my PayPal, and so I walked down with $20. I figured that was plenty for a $10 game and $5 for the card. And no, there's a $20 minimum. So I walked back home and then walked back to Walmart, got the card and the money to PayPal, went on to GOG.com, and that time it finally worked. I'm like, great. That was on a Friday. So I figured Monday, we'll start playing the game. That's when the CRPG addict announced that he would begin playing the game himself, most probably. Monday, my kid calls in sick. So, thankfully, she went to school today, and now we can play. So, playing this completely blind. Never played this before. I've played the King's Quest and Space Quest games, and the King's Quest remakes. I've done Let's Plays up. Now, naturally, I'm playing a mage. CRPG Addict is playing a thief, and Adventure Gamer is playing a fighter, I'm pretty sure. That, and I've looked all over on YouTube and haven't found anyone doing a mage Let's Play of this game. Most people are playing thief, and there was like two fighter Let's Play walkthroughs, playthroughs that I found. So, yeah, let's fill that niche, a void, or whatever. Let's play a mage. Points available, 50. Now, I notice when I move my mouse around, the music kind of stutters. Hopefully that's not normal. I do want to, you know, be a little diversified. Okay, I can't put anything in stealth. Points available. I can't put anything in any of these. How about strength? Okay, I got a right click. I think there's an open door spell. Oh! Now my points are gone. Okay, I can't change that. I can't change dodge back what it is, but parry. Can you change these? Oh yeah, you can change these up too. I can't just put one point in something. Weapon use, parry. Throwing, climbing. What's more important? Yeah, no pick locks. I say the climb is pretty important. Throwing? Now throwing, I use 15 points to just, you put 5 in it. Same here. Parry. Let's throw. We'll throw things. Probably gonna die a lot, guys, because I have no idea. It seems like a quiet little town. On the porch ahead of you are two people. The standing one is large, rather ugly, and playing with a yo-yo. The seated person smoking a pipe looks like he might be the sheriff. Okay. Man with the pipe greets you. Welcome to our town. You were lucky to have made it down through the mountains before the snow blocked the pass again. It's gotten pretty dangerous outside of town, I understand. Many monsters have been trapped around here with the late snow. Between them and the brigands, we certainly could use a hero around here. I am Sheriff Schultz Meisterson. This is Otto von Goon, my assistant. Good luck in your quest. Why, thank you. So I can look at things. If this is a town water supply, no wonder nobody ever comes here. Schultz appears to be an affable old coot, content to smoke his pipe. There's a hardness behind his eyes, however, that gives you reason to believe that he's no pushover. There's more than a hint of ogre about this strange and bulky character. He seems cheerful, though. Gosh, that's an authentic whamma blamma, three scoops of mana, hilarious, gregarious, floats in the areas, yo-yo. Really? Alright. Door of the sheriff's office. The windows glow from the light inside. The sign reads, Hero's Tale Inn. Not much to look at. There's a sign on the door of the barbershop. It says, Out to Lunch. If I look at myself. What a guy! Hero's Tale Inn. Unhand that sheriff. Can't do much with that. Let's talk to Otto then. You get no response. If that was his name. Interesting. Okay, I can ask about these things. Ask about the mountain. You should know. You came down from there. Yeah, true. Town. This town was named after the barons of Spielburg. It used to be a lively place to be before the brigands came and drove all the business away. You can find a place to stay at the inn next door. You can learn about jobs available at the guild hall down the street. If you are interested in magic, you should visit the magic shop. There are still plenty to do and see here in Spielburg. The inn. Go talk to the innkeeper. He will help you there. The guild hall. The guild hall is at the southwest corner of town. If you're looking for work, that's a good place to go. Let me ask about something else. Adventure? You'll need to talk to the Baron about that, or go ask Wolfgang down at the guild hall, which is just down the street. Okay, I'm getting this idea. We should go to this guild hall. So maybe you're going to be a hero? Well, we could surely use one around here. What with all the brigands? The Baron? Baron Stefan keeps mostly to himself. Or Stefan? At his castle north of here. We haven't seen him here in town for years. Wolfgang? Wolfgang down at the guild hall. He is... Well, is one of the one to talk to about monsters. He's had a lot of experience with them. The guild hall? Yeah, I saw that. Name? Okay, he just introduces himself again. Can I go in here? The door appears to be locked, and breaking into the sheriff's office might evoke the wrath of Otto von Goon. Alright, let's not evoke the wrath. Let's see what's in this Hero's Tale. Is that the inn? Hero's Tale Inn? It's a Khajiit. Welcome, traveler, to the Hero's Tale Inn. I am Shamin at your service. May you find what you seek here. You know, that's long before any Khajiit. Alright, so look around here. That would never work. The table is too bored and loggy to respond. Planks anyway, you tell it. I can't look at the fire? Stop that. What do you think this is? Some kind of biker bar? To whom are you trying to speak? Oh, I thought I was on... I was trying to look at things. A well-fed fire purrs happily in the fireplace. I get it. The fire purrs. The warmth of the fire feels good on such a chilly day. The proprietor of the inn apparently thinks so, too. Cats always seem to gravitate... to a warm hearth. You see a small-like creature known as a catta. You've heard that cattas are common in the southern deserts. Okay. This is the idiot half-brother candle. It's only half-bright. This is the brighter candle. Collection of designer plates loaned to the Hero's Inn by Mary Meister. This looks like an alpine inn, complete with dishes on the wall and heavy beams on the ceiling. It is pleasantly warm, and the aroma of strange spices fills the air. You see a small cat-like creature known as a catta. You've heard that cattas are common in the southern deserts. This authentic Polynesian mask is far, far from home. One of Harem Plugmeister's double-barreled spittoons. A door to some other room. Perhaps the proprietor can tell you what's in there. Perhaps, perhaps. Poke. You can think better of it. Those claws look sharp. Alright, let's talk to the catta. Very good food, very good drink. Finest in town. Sit and rest. You'll be served by my Shema. It's about a room. Very nice room, very soft beds. Finest in town. Only 5 silvers a night. Oh, yeah, that's the food. Merchant? My friend Abdullah is recovering from his robbery last week. He should be here around supper time. Wealth? I hope to return to my homeland with the prophets Abdullah, Shema, and I would make from the caravan. Now I fear we will remain here until someone deals with the brigands and returns our stolen trade items. That's about the brigands. I know little about them except they must be wealthy now. Robbery? Alas, the brigand stole all of Abdullah's wealth and mine own when he robbed his caravan. Now I will be forced to stay in this wet, cold land. Shapir. A land of golden sand and tall mountains, a city of tall buildings and winding streets, a place where catta can bask in the sun as they sell things in the bazaar. It is our homeland and a place we long to be. Yep, sounds familiar. Caravan. In my homeland, a caravan is the only way to travel from city to city. Do you ask about something else? Name, town. Spielburg is a sad place for an innkeeper, for few travelers visit because of the brigands. Otto? There is no end to the food that one can eat. How about the sheriff? He comes in with his wife sometimes for food. He is very wise and generous. Spielberg, this is a cold land for the catta. I'm beginning to think Bethesda ripped off this character. Because both them and the Khajiit, they really missed their homeland and complained about it being cold here. Alright. So if I sit down, I get served by Shema, or the Shema. You see a sign that says, please don't touch, besides Shemin is watching you. Alright, do I just walk over there? Or is that just, can I not actually do that? It's just for... All right. I don't know. Sit, rest. Well, I don't know how to sit or rest. What's in there? Can I go through there? Or just out? Yeah, let's go out. Aha. Okay, there's a little eye thing watching me. I got my own little eye right here. The eye of the magic shop door seems to be watching you. Okay. She's the only sane person here. At least she's not off her rocker. This looks like a nice, neat little house. There is a grandmotherly little old lady rocking on the front porch. Judging from what the sign says, the building at the end of the street is the Guild Hall. You can just see a thin thread of light under the door, so there's probably someone inside. You have come to the end of the main street. The town wall is to the south. You have an eerie feeling that someone is watching you. Well, like something. Okay. Well, let's talk to her then. She's really sleeping soundly and doesn't notice your presence. Zzz. Okay. Grumph, snort, humph, humph. And zzz. Okay. Alright, I know we haven't done that much in this episode at all, really. I'm going to take a look inside the guild hall next episode. I'm going to try to keep these episodes a little bit shorter, more like 20 minutes, not like my usual a Skyrim 30 to 40 minute epics. So, some people complain that the length is a little too big, but I'm trying to actually get somewhere in Skyrim, so I gotta... But I gotta upload large episodes of that. But this is good, I think. Join me next time when we enter the guild hall. See you next time, and this is Nord Pudding.